Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ahlan wa sahlan wa marhaban bikum. Welcome back. And we ended off with the ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the dua of the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allahumma laka aslamtu wa bika amantu wa alayka tawakkaltu. Oh Allah, in you I believe. Oh Allah, to you I submit. Oh Allah, to you I believe, and in you I place my trust. Right, that is a hadith that is muttafaqun alayh. It is agreed by all of the Sahaba, specifically Al-Bukhari wa Muslim is the one that has authenticated that hadith. Abu Dharr al-Ghafari radiallahu ta'ala anhum, he says that the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam had read the following ayah, وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ حتى فرغ من الآية ثم قال يا أبا ذر لو أن الناس كلهم أخذوا بها لكفتهم رواه ابن ماجه وأحمد. That the Nabi Islam read the ayah وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make a way out for that person. وَيَرْزُقُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ, and will reward him. You won't know where the reward, you won't know where the things are coming from. وَمَنْ يَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ فَهُوَ حَسْبُهُ. You place your trust in Allah Ta'ala, that is enough for you. So the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam read this ayah, Surah Al-Talaq, it is ayah number 223. When the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam finished, says, يَا أَبَذَرْ لَوْ أَنَّ النَّاسَ كُلَّهُمْ أَخَذَ بِهَا لَكَفَّتْهُمْ. If all of the people were to really take to this ayah, then this will be enough for them. Yes, Jamaatul Muslimin, respected viewers, when you place your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this brings contentment to your heart. This brings peace and tranquility. It saves you from shaitan in actual fact. And therefore the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam used to teach his sahaba, the dua, morning, night, and so on. Sun breaks through, fajr in the morning. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, he says, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إذا خرج الرجل من بيته فقال بسم الله توكلت على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله يقال حينئذ هديت وكفيت ووقيت فتتنحى له الشياطين فيقول له شيطان آخر كيف لك برجل قد هدي وكفي ووقي. That the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said that when a person leaves their house and says Bismillah tawakkaltu ala Allah, in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I place my trust in Allah ta'ala, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There's no will, there's no power, there's no movement, there's no nothing except by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it is said to that person, هديت وكفيت ووقيت. You have been guided, you have been defended, and you have been protected. And shaitan then moves away from him, and another shaitan says to him, what are you going to do about a person that has been guided, that has been defended, and that has been protected? So therefore shaitan and Satan does not have an authority over those who place their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala clearly says in Surah An-Nahl, ayah number 99, إِنَّهُ لَيْسَ لَهُ سُلْطَانٌ عَلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. The shaitan does not have power or authority on those who believe and place their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, as slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must realize that tawakkul is min a'mal al-qulub. That is things that comes from the heart. It doesn't conflict with having to put things into action and to take precautionary measures, because tawakkul mahallu fil qalb. The place of tawakkul is in the heart. And to take precaution measures to do something obviously comes from the body. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam joins these two elements in one hadith when the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, "Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billah wa la ta'jaz." Maybe we should take this hadith from the beginning. The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, "Al-mu'min al-qawi khayrun wa habbu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if. Wa fi kullin khayr. Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billah wa la ta'jaz. Fa in asabaka shay'un fala taqul anni fa'altu kadha wa kadha. Walakin qul qaddara Allah wa ma sha'a fa'ala fa inna law taftahu 'amalu shaytan." Says the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam in this beautiful hadith, "Al-mu'min al-qawi khayrun wa habbu ila Allah min al-mu'min al-da'if." What does it mean? That the mu'min that is strong is better and more loved in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than one that is weak. But in both there are good. Fi kullin khayr. Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billah wa la ta'jaz. Be eager for that which benefits you. Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billah, and seek the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa la ta'jaz, and don't be weak. فَإِنْ أَصَابَكَ شَيْءٌ فَلَا تَكُلُّ أَنِّي فَعَلْتُ كَذَا وَكَذَا. If a calamity befalls you, if a difficulty befalls you, if a heartache befalls you, don't say, "If only I did so, it would have been like this, and if only did that, it would have been like that," and so on. Or this one did that, and this one did that. Don't say that. Rather say, قَدَّرَ اللَّهُ وَمَا شَاءَ فَعَلَ. This is predetermined by Allah Ta'ala. Allah does as He wish. Predetermined by Allah Ta'ala, and Allah does. فَإِنَّ اللَّهُ تَفْتَحَ حَمْلُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Because that word "if" opens the door to shaitan. What do we say in terms of this that we are busy with? The Nabi Islam says in this hadith, "Ihris ala ma yanfa'uk wasta'in billah wa la ta'jaz." And you see the Nabi Salatu Wasalam then encourages taking precautionary measures, al-akhd bil-asbab, as well as seeking the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Tawakkul is something that shows that you are determined by Allah ta'ala. It shows that you are devoted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It shows that you are looking for precaution. And a man comes to the Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I'm sure we all know the hadith, comes to, he says, "Ya Rasulullah, aqiluha wa tawakkal, aw utlukuha wa tawakkal." He has his naqa, his camel with him, and he says, "Ya Rasulullah, do I tie this camel up and to put my trust in Allah Ta'ala, or do I leave it running wild and put my trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" The Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, "I'qilha wa tawakkal." Tie your camel and then put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, nothing wrong with putting your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and taking precautionary measures. Taking precautionary measures, where we leave off doing the action. In other words, I make dua, "Ya Allah, grant me money, but I don't go work." You must go work. There must be action in order to achieve something. There were a group of people that understood this ayah wrong, natawakkal ala Allah, or the concept wrong, and they left off that taking precautionary measures. So what happened? They went for Hajj. They said, "We're not taking any food, we're not taking any money," and whatever the case may be, we place our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, huwa raziquna. He is the one that provides us sustenance. And when they just got to Mecca, entering Mecca, they had to start asking people like beggars, because they didn't bring. And for that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends down, وَتَزَوَّدُوا فَإِنَّ خَيْرَ الزَّادِ التَّقْوَى. Increase in, meaning that precaution measures, take that extra money worth, and the best increase you can have is taqwa Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to be righteous. So what the ayah then taught them is you would have to increase in money and in food. In money and in food. Like we said, Tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it helps you submit to the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It helps you come to a point where you are happy with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put out. In Surah Tawbah, ayah number 51, قُلْ لَا يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ لَنَا هُوَ مَوْلَانَا وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلِتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. That submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we spoke about, قُلْ لَا يُصِيبَنَا إِلَّا مَا كَتَبَ اللَّهُ. Say nothing, no affliction will come to us except that which Allah has written out for us. هُوَ مَوْلَانَا. He is our Lord, He is our helper, He is our protector. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلِتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. It is but on Allah Ta'ala that the believers place their trust. So therefore, a mu'min that is qawi, a mu'min that is strong, is a mu'min that is mutawakkil. That place their trust in Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, and you're happy for what Allah Ta'ala has put out for you, happy what Allah has proportioned for you. And you don't go on complaining, you know, this is not that, that is, I feel at a loss, and I feel regret about this, that. And the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, فَإِنْ غَلَبَكَ شَيْءٌ فَقُلْ قَدْرُ اللَّهِ وَمَا شَاءَ وَإِيَّاكَ وَلَّوْ فَإِنَّ لَوْ تَفْتُ حَمْلُ الشَّيْطَانِ. Same hadith that we talked with. Says, if you are overpowered by something, then say whatever Allah Ta'ala has put out is going to come to fore, it's going to happen. وَإِيَّاكَ وَلَّوْ, and I warn you about this word. Look, if opens the door to shaitan. And you and me, we know. We can say how many times, if for this, that, and the other. So therefore, we fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we're aware that tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to bring us contentment, is going to put our minds at ease, it's going to bring us stability, and it prepares us for the greatest success of all. It prepares you for your entry into the Jannah. بغير حساب, without being questioned about it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ غُرَفًا تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا نِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, those people who believe and does righteous work, لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ غُرَفًا, we will give them high in dwellings within the Jannah. تجري من تحت الأنهار, underneath which rivers flow. Permanently they will be in there. نعم أجر العاملين. What a great reward for those who have put it in action, that there is responsibilities. الذين صبروا على ربهم يتوكلون. These are the people that have shown patience and perseverance and placed their trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So therefore, when we reach that pinnacle or that height of tawakkul ala Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, And by the way, we reach that without having desire what is in the hands of other people. We say happy with what Allah Ta'ala has given us. So therefore, who places their trust on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah Ta'ala will protect you. Allah Ta'ala will raise you darajat. Allah Ta'ala will prevent shaitan from coming closer to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you in rizq and grant you yani that which will bring you on the day of your Qiyamah in good stead with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In conclusion, hadith in Tirmidhi, the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam says, لو أنكم كنتم توكلون على الله حق توكله لرزقتم كما ترزق الطير تغدو خماصا وتروح بطانا. If you were to put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like you ought to, then Allah ta'ala will give you rizq like he gives that to a bird. And then, and then we'll be able to lay back and enjoy. So therefore, our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we make dua Allah ta'ala, make us min al-muttaqeen, wa min al-muhsineen, wa min ibad al-salihin. All those that are sick, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them shifa. All those that are fasting, Allah ta'ala grant them jannatul firdaus. Allah make us all min al-muttaqeen, wa min al-muhsineen, wa min ibad al-salihin. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alameen.